Hello and welcome to the NANOSENSORS product screencast on our Magnetic Force Microscopy AFM probe series. NANOSENSORS develops and manufactures tips for scanning probe microscopy. My name is Thomas Sulzbach and I'm responsible for research and development at NANOSENSORS. Today, I want to give you a short introduction to the different probes available for magnetic force microscopy. Magnetic force microscopy, or short MFM, allows visualization of magnetic features at a sample surface, independent of surface topography. This example is a visualization of magnetic bits at a hard disk. The left part of the image is showing the topography of the hard disk surface, and on the right, the magnetic features written onto the hard disk are visible. In general, our MFM probes are based on our well-established Point Probe Plus series. And specifically, the Point Probe Plus FM probe type is used because the cantilever is soft enough to ensure a high sensitivity, but also stiff enough to avoid that the tip snaps into contact with the sample surface. Stable operation in non-contact mode or tapping mode is possible. For resolution and optimum signal-to-noise ratio, the shape of tip and the properties of the magnetic coating are crucial. For high resolution, a high aspect ratio of the tip and a small diameter of the tip apex are needed. By that, the tip gets close to an ideal bar-shaped magnet with smallest possible end phase. Moreover, the distance between tip and sample should be made as small as the experiment allows. Fortunately, a small tip diameter will help for that. Signal-to-noise ratio is enhanced by a high magnetic moment of the tip, but such a high magnetization will disturb the magnetization of your sample, and usually high magnetic moment is correlated with the volume of magnetic material. Therefore, the tip diameter will increase with magnetic moment and worsen the lateral resolution. At the end, the choice of probe will always be a trade-off between resolution demands and signal-to-noise ratio needs under the frame conditions set by your specific magnetic sample. In many cases, lateral resolution will be of high importance. Therefore, I will start with a comparison of resolution performance achievable with different MFM probe types. The sample used here is an experimental hard disk where the bit length has been varied. The upper images are showing the magnetic features and the SEM images below are showing the tip type used for the measurement. You will clearly see that you can detect the largest magnetic bits with all probes, but you will also see that resolution increases from left to right. Smaller bits are clearly resolved and details of the larger bits get visible. But if you look carefully, you will also see that the signal strength decreases as well. The first probe of our MFM series to be presented here is the most established one and it allows a stable imaging of various types of samples with a high signal-to-noise ratio. The coercivity of the magnetic material is about 300 Oersted and its remanence magnetization is about 300 electromagnetic units per cubic centimeter. As for all other MFM probes, these coating characteristics are measured at a plane surface because a measurement directly at the tip apex is not possible. But it is known that the shape of magnetic material has a strong impact on the effective magnetic properties. Therefore, one could expect that the effective coercivity and the effective remanence magnetization at the tip apex is even higher. The volume of magnetic material that interacts with your sample depends on the size and distance of magnetic features of your sample. Therefore, it is difficult to estimate the effective magnetic moment at the tip, but it is in the order of 10 to the minus 13 electromagnetic units. We guarantee a tip radius of curvature of the coated probe of less than 50 nanometers, and the magnetic resolution achievable with these probes is usually better than 50 nanometers. For applications requiring reduced disturbance of the sample, we recommend our MFM probe version with lower magnetic moment, which in this case is about half of the moment of that of the standard MFM probes. With 250 oersted, the coercivity is almost as high as for the standard MFM probes, which ensures a stable tip magnetization during your experiment. The coating is a bit thinner than that of our standard MFM probe. Therefore, the radius is below 30 nanometers and typically a lateral resolution of better than 35 nanometers can be achieved in the magnetic image. A typical application example of our low moment magnetic force microscopy probes is imaging the magnetic domains of patterned soft magnetic thin films. In this example, the magnetic domain structure of a circular dot of nickel cobalt thin film was investigated. Bowtie shaped domains can be seen in the overview image left and the close up in the mid. Both images were acquired with point probe plus low momentum MFM R probes. The right hand image is showing the result of the same measurement performed with a standard point probe plus MFM R probe with higher magnetic moment. It can be seen clearly that the domain structure flips randomly from one scan line to the next, which can be explained by the impact of the tip stray field to the sample. Magnetic force microscopy probes with low coercivity can also be used for soft magnetic samples, or they may be used for samples with extremely strong stray fields. In the first case, the low coercivity of the tip magnetization helps to reduce disturbance of the sample magnetization, because if the tip magnetization is softer than that of the sample, the tip magnetization will change its orientation before the sample magnetization is disturbed. Unfortunately, this effect may cause some troubles for interpretation of the measurement results. On the other hand, a stable situation could be expected in case of samples with very strong stray fields. In this situation, the tip magnetization of low coercivity probes will always follow the magnetization of the sample, whereas hard magnetic MFM tips would flip randomly. The coercivity of point probe plus low coercivity MFM R probes is as low as 0.75 oersted, but its magnetization is comparable to that of our hard magnetically coated MFM probes. The tip radius is below 30 nanometers, and typically magnetic features of down to 35 nanometers can be resolved. The effect of modulation in tip magnetization under the impact of sample stray field can be seen already in the hard disk sample that I showed to you before. The stray field of the larger magnetic bits is sufficient for reversing the orientation of tip magnetization. This causes a contrast reversal at the areas of strongest sample stray field, which is clearly visible in the left image. In the right image, you see a comparison measurement performed with a standard MFM probe, showing the alternating magnetic orientations of the magnetic bits. In the left image, an additional fine pattern seems to appear. In reality, this is an artifact of the flipping tip magnetization. In this application, of course, the use of soft magnetic tip is not very reasonable, but you may imagine that it would get reasonable for samples that could randomly cause a reorientation of hard magnetic tip coatings. Then the behavior of soft magnetic tips is more stable. Our MFM probe with highest lateral resolution performance is the super sharp silicon magnetic force microscopy probe. The combination of our extremely sharp and high aspect ratio super sharp silicon tip with a very thin hard magnetic coating results in utmost lateral resolution in magnetic imaging. The radius of the coated tip is less than 50 nanometers, and magnetic features of less than 25 nanometers can be resolved. The coercivity is 125 oersted, and the magnetic moment is about 1/4 of that of standard MFM probes moment. Here, the resolution performance of our super sharp silicon MFM probes has been demonstrated by imaging extremely small magnetic bits at the experimental hard disk mentioned before. As you will see in the right image, magnetic bits of a length down to 25 nanometers are resolved and even smaller features are visible. Finally, I want to show you that we provide special versions of MFM probes for application under ultra-high vacuum conditions. In UHV, the cantilever damping is determined by intrinsic inelastic effects within the cantilever. As they are made of single crystalline silicon, such effects are very weak and the mechanical quality factor is high. But in case of amorphous coatings added to the cantilever, the damping is dramatically increased and the quality factor may drop by 1 or 2 orders of magnitude. Therefore, we offer MFM probe variants with partial coating of the cantilever, which keeps the high quality factor of well above 30,000 under UHV conditions. The microscope images are showing the tip and the detector side of such a cantilever with partial coating. The measurement curve on the right is showing a typical resonance curve obtained under UHV conditions. This particular cantilever has a quality factor of more than 60,000. This is a tabular overview of the magnetic force microscopy probes offered by NANOSENSORS, with all technical data as presented before. We provide 4 different probes with hard or soft magnetic coating, differing in coercivity, magnetic moment and resolution capability, plus 2 variants especially designed for application under ultra-high vacuum conditions. You may use this table to choose the best magnetic force microscopy probe for your specific application and experiment. Thanks for your interest and your attention. If you have any question, a feedback or a need for more information, please contact us at info@nanosensors.com. You can also download our brochure on magnetic force microscopy probes from nanosensors.com/downloads.